Evropska unija finansijski podržava projekte razvoja lokalnih samouprava, a u programu EU-PRO učestvuje ukupno 99 lokalnih samouprava u Srbiji. Među njima ima i mnogo onih sa juga Srbije, a Južne Vesti su skoro i pisale o tome kako je više od 2 miliona evra uloženo u infrastrukturne projekte na jugu Srbije, koji bi trebalo da krenu već sa ove prolećne građevinske sezone. Evropska unija je nešto na što se Srbija oslanja i čije mišljenje traži u političkom smislu. To će upravo takođe biti tema današnjeg razgovora sa ambasadorom Evropske unije u Srbiji, Semom Fabricijem. Mr. Fabrici, welcome to our program.
Thank you very much.
First of all, you are here today on Southern Serbia to see the realization of this EU-PRO program. EU contribute to the micro and small companies. You saw them today. Is that correct? Are you satisfied with the realization of this program?
Well, let me say that I'm very happy to be in south of Serbia today. It's been a busy day in Bosilegrad, in Preševo, and I'm back to Vranje, and I will continue also my program tomorrow with a further visit in Vranje and in Bujanovac. Is it true that this is an area where the European Union has been active? This is for me the second time during my term, but is European Union has been active in the past 20 years with a number of social economic development in an area where there's still some economic gap, social gap that need to be bridged.
Yes, but EU-PRO program is a 3-year-old program.
Yes, exactly. The specific project EU-PRO is a continuation of a number of projects we have done in the past. This one is we launched it last year, will last 3 years, and will cover a number of projects in the economic and social development that the communities, local communities, present to us in a competitive way, and the project will be chosen and approved. I saw some of them today, together with other projects we have realized in the past. Tomorrow we'll visit the surgical block here in Vranje.
It was opened in December.
I visited here the last time I was in Vranje. It was still was completed. Still, there were the equipment to be brought in. I'm happy to see it's working. I saw also the one in Preševo, the maternal ward was already open in 2016. Tomorrow will be in the faculty in Bujanovac, the Faculty of Economy, which has been funded by the European Union. So we are very happy. We see a strong demand, especially from the local municipality, to accede to the European Union project. I encourage them to look into EU-PRO, but also to other projects like Horizon 2020, Erasmus, another project that we run for different component, the economy, the education, the society.
You will soon have a new round of projects for small and micro business.
Exactly. We will launch a second round in this year, but also tomorrow we will award in the Bujanovac faculty a number of awards to companies as small and medium enterprises who have been beneficiary of our project. In Serbia, as in any other economy of the European Union, SMEs are around 90% of the economy, they're the backbone of the economy, so we are very happy that Serbian SMEs are applying and are winning and implementing projects with the European Union.
Okay, and what are your impressions, small and micro business, do they know how to apply, how are their project managers, are they good at applying?
I would say yes, also because they are not new to the system. As I said at the beginning, the European Union, through different projects, has been active in this part of the country in the past 20 years. So there's a quite a good knowledge in the local administration or also in the small and medium enterprise, but part of our work is also to advise them, guide them on how to make a project, and always we have more demand of project that we can offer, which is always a good sign. So it means that the companies knows what they are looking for. And we are happy that they are working with us. And since the success of this project, we are also planning a continuation of this project also for the next year. We are programming.
And what are the plans for
the
next year?
The plan is to assess when the project will be, this project EU-PRO will be completed, to make also an assessment of what has been the strength of the project. Is something need to be changed? And we're already thinking in the programming for 19 and 20 to allocate further financial resources for continuation of this, this project.
Okay, let's talk about the political situation in Serbia, if it's okay with you. You know, what about demarcation, the one of the solution that Serbia offers to Kosovo, according to Prime Minister of Foreign Affairs, Ivica Dačić? In your opinion, is that a good solution?
Well, let me say there is, I presume you refer to the dialogue between Pristina and Belgrade. The European Union is, as you know, and certainly your audience knows, is the facilitator of this dialogue. The High Representative Mogherini is personally committed in facilitating this dialogue. Our line, our indication is that Belgrade and Pristina should arrive to a legally binding comprehensive agreement to solve all the issues on the table in accordance with international law and the European Union standards. So we do not enter in, we do not comment in any of ideas or suggestions that have been put forward. Is for the Pristina and Belgrade to agree on something that is sustainable and realistic. So any this idea that you mentioned, any other one on this, we don't comment on the content of what the agreement would be.
Okay, but a couple of days ago, President Vučić, as media says, asked the EU to make additional effort to make Kosovo turn back taxes as they were a couple of months ago. So what about this request?
You mean the tariff?
Yes, tariff.
Yes, no, the tariff is a separate issue and is a unilateral step that the authorities in Pristina have adopted in November last year. Since the very first day, we said that these tariffs are not in agreement with the understanding of the Central and European Free Trade Agreement, and so we have asked Pristina to revoke this tariff, and this is our position continues today.
Okay, the President Vučić is also announcing an elections this year. How do you see it? Considering situation with Kosovo and protests of citizens and opposition parties in Serbia?
Well, for the decision, Serbia will should vote in 2020, will be the natural
yes.
Date of a legislative election. If there will be earlier election, it is totally in the prerogative, the sovereignty of the Serbian authorities to call for elections, so it's not for me to comment. On the demonstration you mentioned, so on the other issues I already
That would be my next question. How much is EU interested in protests in Serbia, demonstrations?
I think that the protests or the demonstration are an expression of democracy. Is a right to assembly, demonstrate is an fundamental right. We have certainly followed the demonstration, and certainly we appreciate the demonstration are peaceful.
If we are talking about fundamental human rights, Prime Minister partner gave a birth to a child, and if we consider that Serbian society is very traditional and very closed when gay marriages are and gay marriages are not recognized in our law system, is this a good thing for fundamental human rights in Serbia?
I would say absolutely, and I congratulate the Prime Minister and her partner for the Igor, the new baby born. I think is an is also an expression that Serbia is recognized, certainly bring to the fore, to the front person, especially as a Prime Minister, a person of LGBT community. So I would say that I understand there is might be a conservatism in the society, but at the same time you have the Prime Minister from the LGBT community. So I think this is what Serbia is about. is a country with a different multifaceted society. So I think this is certainly a positive element.
Okay, there are different comments in the media, so that's why I'm asking. Serbia is candidate for EU, so how can you rate our negotiation progress? If you consider that the government is now finishing a new action plan for the chapter 23.
Well, Serbia started the accession in 2014, so right now we are entering in the fifth year of negotiation. The progress are more advanced into the reform to enter the Europe from a European Union point of view, and certainly more advanced in the economic area. We have seen also this reform are also producing result. The economy is growing, unemployment is dropping, but certainly more can be done, and certainly we encourage the authorities to do more to make the economy growing more faster in a sustainable way. Where we see still where the progress need to be enhanced, if you want to say so, is an area what we call of the rule of law. So the role of the parliament, the independency of the judiciary, freedom of expression. There's a number of areas where we are encouraging the government to do faster, to do more. But it also calls to the whole society to be on the same side. It's not just the responsibility of the government; it's the responsibility of the parliament and the society at whole. In terms of the action plan, we are happy that the government has put forward a revision action plan. For your audience, is the revision of the plan the Serbian authorities are committed to implement the reform of rule of law. The government realized that there were some delays in the process compared to the previous action plan, has produced the action plan, is a 200-page document. I invited yesterday, before traveling to Vranje, the Minister of Justice together with the EU ambassador to know more about this plan. We are happy that the NGOs and other component of the civil society are making their comments on what this action plan contains. I encourage all the stakeholders in the Serbian society, the media, the civil society, in the parliament, in the business, to look into the action plan, which is the Serbian roadmap for introducing the reform of rule of law. So in that sense, we cannot but be very strong ally, strong encourager to make reform that mean something. So reform that introduce meaningful fundamental right, more democracy, an independent judiciary system, and more free press and freedom of expression.
Okay, where is Serbia if you compare it with other Balkan countries in democracy?
Well, difficult for me to make any comparison. Each country has its own trajectory, has its own history. Certainly, what we ask to Serbia is what we ask in all other countries within the European Union and outside the European Union, the candidate countries. So all the countries have to move in the same direction, aspiring to the same, sharing the same values, and aspiring to the same goal. So in that sense, there's no difference.
Do we need more muscles to move forward in that direction?
Certainly, you need a little bit of a more sprint, if you want to say so. But also, the accession is also a process. It's not something that you can change a country in the case you made before. The values, the interests, takes time to be there. The reform an instrument to make an entrance to the European Union. So the more the reform are meaningful, the more are strong, deep, and meaningful reform, the faster is for Serbia to get closer to European Union. I would say muscle and breath and also stamina.
Okay, for the end, one more question. Do you think we are on the dark side of history, Serbia?
No, I don't think so. I believe that Serbia should consider itself on the bright side of the future if the future is the European Union.
Okay, thank you very much on this conversation.
Pleasure, thank you.
Vi ste gledali emisiju 15 minuta. Naš sagovornik bio je ambasador Evropske unije Sam Fabrici, a ja sam Vesna Milić.